So today we are worshiping Srila Gurudev. To please Vedvyas, we are publishing all the words of our Gurudev. As it is, as he spoke, everywhere he went, and we'll put them in the walls of our temple. And this will be our temple, Gurudev's Vani, his teaching. And this is most pleasing to Vedvyas and the whole Guru Parampara, because this is his family. Every Guru in our line, they have their family. So this is Gurudev's family, and so we're putting his words everywhere. To remind ourselves, who is our caretaker, who is our provider, who is our nourisher, who is our family member, who is taking care of us, who is taking us in their hands and bringing us to Sri Krishna. All right, so we're very happy today. Jai Shri Gurudev. First unboxing. Today is Purnima, full moon, so all the books are white and gold. Jai Shri Gurudev. It's Hawaii, 1999. Let's see what everything comes. Philippines, 1999. Hawaii, 1998. Holland, 1999. France, 1999. Okay. Let me open this so it doesn't make so much noise. So many new books. These are all new, first time published. First time. All right? Very, very beautiful. And two more are ready to be published. Vrindavan doesn't waste time, right? During New Braj, two new books, yes? 2 weeks, two books. What's the problem? Okay. So we're going to have all these in the bookshelf with Gurudev's beautiful face facing us so we can see all his beautiful darshans. What endeavors you are doing, they should all be to please Krishna. If you are eating a meal and you are thinking this is to please Krishna, then that is bhakti. Why are you coming here? So that Krishna will be pleased. You should think that if I am going in this association, then I will be qualified to serve Krishna. Why are you sleeping? Why are you sleeping? At night, why do you sleep? If you are sleeping so that in the morning I will be fresh to serve Krishna, then that sleeping is bhakti. Beautiful. Bhakti is always Uttama Bhakti, that means topmost. In this world, there are maybe some adulteration in that. For example, uncontaminated water means pure water, meaning that in this water, there is no color, no smell, or adulteration of any kind. It's uncontaminated water. So that's real water. Anything extra that's mixed in, now that's not water. The water that's there is still the essence, is still water. But our bhakti should be pure water. Therefore, Gurudev's mission, he always talked about pure bhakti. Okay? France. San Francisco, 1998. Okay? Costa Rica, 1999. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu especially came to give this. He cannot give Radhika's mood. He can only give the beauty of that, the mood to serve the gopis, especially Radhika in the mood of Rupa Manjari, Rati Manjari. You may be qualified up to this. This beauty is so high that Radha and Krishna both are charmed by that. So we should try to realize all these things in this human form of life. Okay? Shri Gurudev ki jai. So many. Even if you are chanting so much, lakhs and lakhs of holy names, it is not sure that you will have his mercy and that Krishna will be realized. If you are not surrendered, you cannot bind Krishna. So first you should surrender to your Gurudev. If he is qualified, then surrender, and then you should chant and remember. Okay? Even if you chant a little, no harm. Only two rounds, or not even that, no harm. The gopis have no mala, no chanting beads, but yet Krishna is controlled by them because all their efforts are to please Krishna. So we have to understand the mood first. if you are chanting Hare Krishna the whole day and night, if you are reading books the whole day and night, if you are worshipping, it is no use if you have no Sharanagati. Sharanagati means it's a way to realize our love and relationship. It's like a marriage. You work together. There's some kind of working together. If we're all just thinking, I will do as I like, I'm independent jiva, everyone is independent, then this is not Sharanagati. So Gurudev said, first have that, then your chanting has potency. It's interesting, many of these quotes are guru quotes. Who will be a disciple? He is not lazy. He can follow all the orders of Gurudev. If Guru is saying, give your head at once without delay, he will give. Because he knows, my Guru is so powerful, he can do anything. He will wake in the morning before Gurudev and he will sleep after Gurudev. He is always in a serving mood. Only to serve Krishna and the devotees. So what will be Guru's orders? Only serve the devotees. This is what he says. So Gurudev is saying you should serve Guru. And what does Guru say? Serve everyone. So you should be ready to follow. That's bona fide. Serve Krishna and serve everyone. And what does Krishna say? If you are my devotee, you are not my devotee. If you are my devotee's devotee, you are my devotee. This is Krishna saying in scripture. He says, those who say I am Krishna's devotee, they are not Krishna's devotee. Those who are the devotees of Krishna's devotees, meaning those who serve Krishna's devotees with great love, they are Krishna's devotees. Okay? So many beautiful books. Brazil, 1999, volume 41. Can Chaitanya Mahaprabhu ever change the sthayi bhav of Sachimata to the mood of Radhika? So this quote is Gurudev talking about the nature of the soul. And the soul has a relationship with Krishna. He said that relationship is eternal. Even God cannot change that. This is what he's saying here. Even God cannot change your relationship with him. That's eternal. Like Mahaprabhu's, Krishna's mother will never become Krishna's beloved Radharani. Mother is mother, beloved is beloved. Jagannath Mishra is Nanda Baba. He cannot change his mood. He cannot change the mood of Gadadhar Pandit, never. He cannot change the mood of Muradi Gupta. So that's why we selected very essential teachings of our Gurudev as the covers for these books and in the excerpts. And we're publishing as it is, word for word, so that his teachings are immortalized. Gurudev said, what I speak can evaporate into the air, but if it's printed in books, it will stay. Okay, how many churches have been built and crumbled, but the Bible is there? Yes? So this is our Gurudev's Bible. Okay, all the books. In the future, they'll say, volume 39, text this, page this, you know, like Corinthians 8:22. So Vrindavan will say, you know, Vrindavan will be speaking with 300 books here, and they'll say, 2004, volume 128, page 45, Gurudev said this. You don't believe it? Here's the audio. Okay. Australia, 1999. I only want to develop the hearts of the devotees. I am not here for any self-gain, only to give you the message of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in the line of Rupa Goswami and under the guidance of Srila Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj. He told me that I should help the devotees in whom their hearts he has planted the seed of bhakti. Really, they are wanting this thing. Everywhere I go, I feel like this. The devotees are hankering for Harikatha and to develop their hearts. They don't want to go into politics and other bad things, only managing and controlling. They only want pure devotion and love for Krishna and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. They want to know who Rupa Goswami was and what was his mission. So Gurudev's secret was that management becomes easy if everyone has a mood of service and humility and desire to serve together under Vaishnavas. Then the managing and control becomes very easy. Srila Bhaktivedanta Vamana Goswami Maharaj, Bhaktivedanta Trivikrama Goswami Maharaj, and Gurudev, they would have 3 or 4 annual meetings about management. And they would sit down and speak about Harikatha, speak about Krishna. And then they would bring up some management topics and laugh. So some management is necessary, but first we should manage our spiritual progress and our love and affection for devotees. Volume 45. So many sweet prayers. Okay, so everyone can look in the back and read these. First read the back. Then if you have more taste, then read the introduction. Then you open it anywhere and you'll be pulled in. Don't try to read first to end. Open, anyway, I'll give you an example, okay? Okay, ready? I didn't prepare this. Okay. I want that this service of cleaning the Gundicha temple should be given to us. So we were just in Badger, we did the Gundicha cleaning. The king became very happy. So this story is that they had hired workers to clean the temple. But God himself had come as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, no, I will go and clean the temple with all my devotees. Because bhakti doesn't just mean hiding in a corner, chanting, or eating, or sleeping, or speaking great scriptures. Bhakti means getting a broom, cleaning the temple, washing it, taking care of the flowers, taking care of the devotees, cleaning. This is bhakti. So Mahaprabhu said, I will teach this by my own example. I will come and teach by my own example. They were paid for that, but they couldn't clean it properly like the devotees. The hired workers didn't do it with love. They thought, I'll come, I'll get my paycheck, and I'll go. But Mahaprabhu thought the devotees can do it better. Why? And this is our love and our service. So first, the servants of the king used to go to clean the temple. They were paid for that, but they wouldn't do it properly. So Mahaprabhu said, I will go myself. We should not be sense enjoyers. We should go and we should serve. That is our mood. So this is Mahaprabhu's mood. There's a sweet story in the back about Srimati Radhika. So Gurudev always makes together very relevant, important teachings for us, but then he would always give very sweet, so much sweetness. This was his speciality. If you read his books, he gives very relevant, important instructions guiding devotees how to live in their lives. That's what's his speciality. He came to help the followers and disciples of Srila Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada who established a worldwide mission. So Gurudev traveled the world 35 times to help all those devotees understand how to follow bhakti and also relevant instructions how to maintain and develop and serve the mission. So that's why Gurudev's katha is so powerful and so especially important for all devotees. And we're doing this as a museum, a memorial, a library of all Gurudev's teachings. But really, you can open anywhere and get such important teachings. Okay, so like example, USA East Coast, 1998, volume 29. Sometimes, okay, you should think, what am I doing? If you are criticizing and offending, you will think, is this Gurudev's service? I'm always criticizing and offending devotees, this is service? So anywhere you open up, such important instructions. I am doing my Gurudev's service, but I'm criticizing and offending devotees. Then this is not service. You understand? Okay? Then you will not realize all these things. So we must be under the guidance of any pure devotee. If we are not doing so, then that bhakti is not bhakti. That is karma. Actually, it is karma, just fruit of work. So here we are taking the association of our... That's why I said, Guru is a person, Vaishnavas are persons. We always take shelter of these persons. And we take shelter of the high class. That means... who are the dearmost servitors of Krishna, who are the most realized, and they can give us the best guidance how to also become elevated to the ultimate position. We should understand, those who are trying to give us guidance, they don't want to control, they want to help us reach the highest position. Every guru wants everyone to become guru. Guru doesn't mean position, guru means beloved of Krishna, realized. Realizing your position as Krishna's beloved, not just thinking about it, but realizing it, that is guru. So they want everyone to realize that. So Gurudev gives so many important instructions. Anywhere you open, you'll find a very important instruction. So it's like a transcendental, but really, everywhere will teach you, take shelter of Guru. So that means Guru, Sadhu, Sastra. So this is our Sastra, and all our scriptures are here. But we take the guidance to be in association. See, Gurudev is saying here, be under guidance of any pure devotee. So then people say, oh, I just read the book, that's enough. No, Gurudev will say in the book, take guidance of any devotee, any pure devotee. The words of Guru are my only hope. What I have heard or what I hear, the words from Gurudev, I will totally follow them. I have so much belief and faith in the words of Gurudev and the words of Krishna and Sastra. I know that if I will totally follow Gurudev's words, orders, then all my desires will be fulfilled. My Gurudev's instruction, that is the instruction of Sastra, the instruction of Krishna, and of all Vaishnavas. So chitete kuriya aike, we should make our heart one with the words of our Gurudev. That's why we're publishing all these books. Make our hearts one with the words of Sri Gurudev. Okay, so we'll go through the rest of these and then we'll do one more quick kirtan and then a little conclusion. Okay. Such beautiful books. Here this one he's talking very nicely about Swami Prabhupada. Okay. New Braj, 1998. Oh ho, the Braja gopis are so fortunate. In the whole world, Braj Mandal is so glorious, so glorious. Why? Because the Supreme Personality Krishna, bringing all his opulence, adorned with all his sweetness, he has descended to Vrindavan. So Vrindavan is so glorious. Especially the gopis are there, so Vrindavan is glorious. If the gopis are not there, then Vrindavan is not so glorious.
Okay, what's page 48?
Page 48? Yeah? Okay, let's go to page 48. Let's finish this quote though. If the gopis are not in Vrindavan with Krishna, then Krishna will only be like Brahman, like zero. So due to the gopis, Krishna is so lovely. All kinds of sweetness is in Krishna. So Vrindavan is so glorious and the gopis are so glorious. Page 48. The instruction, page 48. Sometimes he is bringing the shoes of his father. Sometimes he is stealing butter. Sometimes he is weeping like this. Mother, don't beat me. I am innocent. I am taking an oath that I will never do like this again. You saw this play? Remember? They stole the story. When Jagannath, you saw in Badger?
Yeah.
There was a story. Krishna said, I didn't steal any butter after he stole butter. And then he picked up the shoes. All these stories right here, this was in the drama in New Braj. Krishna tried to pick up the shoes of his father. So God is coming in this baby form and trying to pick up the shoes of his father. So God is love, and love is God. This is our God. God is our God. Our Krishna is the one who is trying to pick up the shoes of his father and who is stealing butter. And then when his mother chastises him, he said, no, I didn't do it. And then she chastises him more. And then he cries. Then he says, I'm going to leave. And then she says, no, don't leave. You didn't steal butter. And then he said, actually, I did steal butter. Oh, you stole butter. Okay, fine. I'm a horrible person. I'll leave. This and that. No, you didn't steal any butter. Please stay with me. You're my son. He said, oh, actually, I did steal butter. I'm sorry. Okay, one more page. Which one? Any? Keep reading here? Malini, what page? Keep reading. Okay. So, you should also know about the relation between Krishna and the gopis. Someone will think Krishna is more superior than the gopis. This may be correct, but Krishna was the one who called the gopis to dance. Krishna was unhappy. He was lacking something, but the gopis are never lacking anything. They were very happy in their houses, chanting and remembering, but Krishna was feeling some lack in him. Although he is the ocean of Ras, that ocean of Ras was dried up. So he wanted to take bath in the ocean of Ras, and that is why on the full moon, today is the full moon. So you pick the full moon, page 48. On the full moon, he played on his flute and he called, O Radhe, O Lalite, O Vishake, you should come and save me. That is why all the gopis came. In Ras Lila, it seems from the outside that the gopis are searching for Krishna. Where is Krishna? Where is Krishna? It seems they became mad searching for him. But if you will go deep, you will see that that is not the case. Krishna is feeling so much separation and he is sitting in Imlitala in Vrindavan. It was there he turned from black to yellow, thinking, where is Radha? Where is Radha? Where is Radha? So Krishna is always searching for, decorating, and following the footsteps of the gopis. Sometimes he's giving his arms around the neck of the gopis. Oh, save me. Why is he asking to be saved? Krishna wants love and affection. He does not want to hear the stavas and stutis of Brahma and all the others, all the Vedic prayers. He wants to hear any gopi chastising him. He prefers the chastisements of the gopis to the prayers of the Vedas.
Well, I got the right journal.
Yes. Again and again, he will come to hear all the chastisements of the gopis. Why have you come to steal our butter? So Krishna is always serving all the gopis. Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, descends only for the reason that he wants to satisfy, he wants to serve, and he wants to make all his devotees and Brajabasis happy. This was the main reason Krishna descended. Okay? Okay, next book. Can someone pick a page? What page?
76.
76. Okay. Left side or right side? Okay, pass the test. Good job. Depending on the mood and type of a devotee's worship, Krishna manifests in different forms. You cannot see these things with your eyes. You need a guru for this. Worldly people cannot see these transcendental things. So it's the beginning of this conversation. The first thing we talked about that you can see with your eyes, but is this what is seeing? You need a guru for this. You cannot see these things with your eyes. Transcendental subjects, material eyes cannot see. We'll have to make more efforts for that. Can you tell if there is fire in your stomach or not? Is there a fire in your stomach? Is there fire here? There's no fire here, right? Yes, there is fire. There is fire in your stomach and in your body. Otherwise, you cannot digest anything. All right, so Gurudev is saying like this. Like fire is everywhere. If you use a matchstick, fire will be created. No, fire will appear. You don't create the fire, right? So fire is everywhere, God is everywhere, but how are you going to see this? In the same way, Parabrahma, the God, he is everywhere. We cannot see him, but he is in every single particle and every single atom. So how do we see that? Therefore, we take shelter of Guru to the point where we can see God everywhere and everything. He knows everything about us, but we don't know him. Okay? So many sweet things. Your worldly knowledge is limited. It is not transcendental. It is only worldly knowledge. By this knowledge, you will become mad and everything will be finished. There's no value at all. If you have eyes now, you may lose them in the future. If someone has a very beautiful body, it may be that they become limp. So we should believe in God. See, Kirtan, very beautiful body, but now your wrist doesn't work. Raising his hand. You have a question? No, he's just showing. No problem. Okay, Kirtan's turn. You can pick a page, okay? Miami, volume 39.
Page 39.
39, okay. Page 39, volume 39. Which side? Okay. Krishna came and touched that girl with his flute, like this. And he took her heart with him and went away. This is a beautiful story. There's a long story about this. She became mad because her heart was not with her anymore. Krishna took her heart and then he went to the cowherding pastures. Now she was only standing and looking. When all the dust came down and Krishna had entered the forest, she was only remembering this pastime. So there's a story that there was one new gopi, new to Vrindavan, and she wanted to go see Krishna. And her mother-in-law and sister-in-law were going to see Krishna. Krishna was coming through the pathway to go to the forest, and they said, stay at home, don't go outside, close the curtains, don't look at that Krishna. She said, where are you going? We are more mature than you. We can tolerate this. We are going to make sure he doesn't do anything wrong. We are capable. You are not capable. If you see Krishna, you'll lose everything. You'll become like a mad lady, mad girl, right? You don't want to be mad. So the mother-in-law went, the sister-in-law went, and when they went, Krishna was coming nearby. She opened her door just an inch, just a little bit, and looked outside, and she came outside a little bit. And Krishna was coming by, and he grabbed the tail of a calf. He held the tail of a calf, and the calf, he was a little boy. Imagine Krishna, 6, 7. And the calf started running. And he held onto the tail, and he rolled through all the dirt and all the dust. He wanted to smear his whole body with the dust of all his devotees. So Krishna thought, by doing this, I'm accomplishing two things. By holding the tail of the calf, I'm getting all the dust of all my Brijabasis, all my friends, all my devotees, and it's coming all over my body. My first task is accomplished. The second task, the primary task, this new gopi is waiting there. She wants to see me, Krishna Darshana Lalasa. I also want to see her. This is love. Prem means there's two sides. Two people participate in love. So Krishna, his devotees, and love itself. This is the three eternal things. What is eternal? Love is eternal. God is eternal. We are eternal. And our loving relationship is eternal. How do we discover that love? That is our process. How do we realize our relationship? That is our process. Guru also has love for Krishna. Therefore, Guru is our bridge to love for Krishna. His love is more realized, so he helps us develop our love through his guidance, through his potency, through his mercy. Therefore, we take shelter of Guru. So Krishna grabbed the tail of the calf, and the calf pulled him right up to the doorstep. So this way, Krishna had an excuse. I didn't try. But Krishna is whispering in the calf's ear, that as Paramatma, the super soul, he is whispering in the soul, that calf, go to that door. And he came right up to the door, and then Krishna jumped up, dusted himself off, pinched her cheek, poked her with his flute, and left. And she was standing there. And Krishna left to the forest, and the sun rose, and the sun stayed up, and she was just standing there. And then her mother came back. Mother-in-law. See, I'll read it now again. She was remembering. Krishna came and touched that girl with his flute, like this. He touched her with his flute, and he took her heart and went away. She became mad because her heart was not with her anymore. Krishna took her heart and went to the cowherding, and she was standing there and just looking. She was only standing there. Her mother-in-law came and asked her, what are you doing? I warned you not to go. I wanted you not to go. Now I see that this black serpent has bit you. So she forcibly took her and brought her inside the house and said, you should churn some yogurt. So she tried to bring her back to her senses, and she gave her a churning stick. You heard the story? All right. So the mother-in-law said, go and churn the yogurt. And then she went to her own job. And this new gopi, she started doing what? She started churning a pot of mustard seeds. And it was making a loud noise, and the mustard smell was coming in the house. The mother-in-law said, what are you doing? Nonsense. You're not churning yogurt, you're churning this mustard seed. I think that this poison has now gone to your brain. The snake bit you, and the poison is going to your brain. You are now infected. Come on with me. Go to the well and bring some water. So she was trying to bring her consciousness back to real sense. But what is real sense? Krishna sense. This is Krishna sense, incense. Incense is helping us understand the scent of Krishna. How fragrant. So she has not lost her sense, she has found her sense. Therefore we pray. Jadavida maya jatara vaibhav, all this material knowledge, everything is just bringing us away from Krishna. But if we can use it to serve Krishna, we can understand everything is used in the service of spirit, everything becomes spiritual. But if it's only material, it's only material. If you use it to serve Krishna, it's all spiritual. You use it to stay away from Krishna, it's all material. Spiritual things become material. You can say, oh, this is spiritual. But if you use it to go farther away from Krishna, now it's only material. Anything material, use a camera for Krishna, then it's Krishna conscious. Use it for Maya, now it's Maya conscious. So her consciousness was completely Krishna conscious. So she achieved the perfection of life. Her mother-in-law said, become Maya conscious again. Look at this external world. Don't look at Krishna. And go to the well. So she took a baby, put a baby in one arm and a pot in another arm, and she went to the well. And she was all Krishna conscious. So she tied the rope around the baby's belly and lowered it into the well. And she was holding the pot like a baby. I'm holding the pot like a baby and tying the rope around the baby's belly. And then all the other ladies at the well said, what are you doing, mad girl? And they stopped her and said, you've lost your sense completely. So then, it was a very little baby. She took the baby in her arms. She was accustomed to go there. So she went there and kept that baby anywhere. She took the rope and tied a knot around the baby. She had no sense at all, whether it was a pot or a baby. The other ladies there, they knew that she had lost her mind to Krishna. They said, oh, a ghost has possessed her. Some said, oh, a ghost has possessed her. But those who knew said, that is not a ghost. It is not a boot. In Hindi or Sanskrit, boot means ghost. So they said, it is not a boot, it's the poot of Nanda Baba. Poot means son. It's not a boot, not a ghost. It's the puta, where the son of Nanda Baba has poisoned her. He has taken her heart. So one should be like that girl, giving his heart purely to Krishna. This is manmana bhava. In the Gita, Krishna's final instruction is offer your heart and your mind to Krishna. Arjuna told Krishna, I cannot do that in this battlefield. I'm in the battlefield. How can I be in trance and serve you? I cannot do this. Then Krishna says, mad bhakto. Try to become a devotee. Perform hearing, chanting, remembering, service, worship, archanam, prayers, vandanam, dasyam, develop the mood of service, sakyam, develop the mood of friendship with Krishna, sakyam. This is one of the nine limbs of bhakti. Krishna is my friend, my real friend. And atma nivedanam, offer your heart to Krishna. So if you can't offer your mind completely like Kalindi, 100% only thinking about Krishna, then be a devotee and gradually hear, chant, remember. She's Paramahansa. Only Krishna, 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 Krishna. Everywhere is Krishna. Left is Krishna, right is Krishna, forward is Krishna, backward is Krishna, southwest is Krishna, northeast is Krishna, everywhere is Krishna. Yes? She knows. Everywhere is Krishna. So if you can't be like that, then okay. Hearing, chanting, remembering. Then gradually. Krishna, Arjuna said, this is still very difficult. I am in the battlefield. How? I will have to fight. I cannot do this. Then Krishna said, Madhyaji. Just offer some worship. Offer a flower. Offer some arati. In Gita, Krishna said, give me one leaf, a little few drops of water, one flower, enough. Why Shravana, nine full limbs of bhakti takes a lot of time. I have to hear this much, I have to chant this much, I have to practice this much, I have to worship this much, I have to develop this mood, that mood. So Krishna said, okay, that's too difficult in the battlefield. Okay, once a day, offer a flower, offer a leaf, offer some water. Okay, easy? Arjuna said, no, I can't do this. How can I offer you a flower on the battlefield? So Krishna said, okay, fine, just mam namaskuru. One time, just say, okay, I am soul, you are God, please accept me, help me in my relationship with you. This is general religion. God is there and I should worship God. I should understand God is there and I offer my salutation, my salute, my pranam, my obeisance to God. One time. This is simple bhakti. But the highest bhakti, like the girl, she's only thinking of Krishna. And he is thinking of her, she is thinking of him. This is called mantra. In the beginning of, I'm working on a book on the Gayatri Mantras. The first mantra from Sasha says, Gayatri Mantra means, not only you are meditating on the object of the mantra, the personality of the mantra is meditating on you. You could do like that. So when you pray to Krishna, Kling Krishnai, when you pray Gopal Mantra, your mantra is so sweet that Krishna, like that, grabbing the tail of the calf, he's coming and he's poking you on the cheek with your flute. I am here. This is real Gayatri Mantra. Yes, he's ever doing this with your mother? Sometimes. book. Malani. Where's Vrindavan? Maybe. Lochan, Pran. So this is Gayatri Mantra. Gayatri Mantra, when you chant it so sweetly, so purely, then Krishna will think, oh, I don't care what the mother-in-law said. I don't care what the sister-in-law said. What you say, that said, I'm going to grab the tail of the calf and come right up to you and say, poke. Hello, I'm here. Like you're doing your mantras. Mantra chanting means you're calling Krishna. Kling Krishnaya Govinda. You're calling Krishna. Come, Krishna, come, come. Then he's showing up and you're thinking, when will I be finished? So it's like you're calling Krishna. He shows up. It's like on a Zoom call. You do a Zoom call with Krishna and he's there and he's like, hello, I'm here. Oh, yes, okay, no problem. I'm on mute and my video is off. And Krishna's waiting and his video is on, his audio is on, but your mute button is on and your volume is down and your screen is off. So your display is off and you have mute on and you're on mute and your video is on mute and Krishna's there waiting. Why are you calling me? Chanting japa, why are you calling me? Hare Krishna. Krishna means vocative case. When we chant Hare, Hare is the vocative case for Radha. I'm calling you, Radha. I'm calling you. Hare, Krishna, I'm calling you, Krishna. So you're calling me, I'm here. I'm non-different from my name, I'm right here. I'm sitting on your lap, I'm slapping your cheek, but you don't even notice? There's one story, Durvasa Muni. See, Kirtan picked the best page. Very good. Durvasa Muni, great sage. He was sitting, doing meditation. And Krishna came by with his friends and he was playing ball and they were arguing who won. They were playing with a big fruit ball. Like you get a grapefruit and you get a big grapefruit and it's mostly just fiber and not so much water. Sometimes they grow too much and you didn't pick it. And so it becomes like a soccer ball. You've ever seen this? Grapefruit soccer ball. And they can play with it. So Krishna's balls are like that. He plays with balls like this with his friends or with big flower, kadamba flowers. Big kadamba flowers, and they play. So he was playing with the boys, and then they were arguing who won. But Krishna really wanted to test the sage's meditation. So he went to the sage, and he began to pull his beard. He had a big beard, and he was sitting there. So Krishna started to pull his beard, and the sage was doing meditation. Oh, I'm meditating on God. And Krishna's thinking, I am God, I'm sitting on your lap, and I'm pulling your beard, and you won't look at me. His eyes were closed. And then Krishna kept pulling. They thought, okay, let's bathe him. So he brought yogurt, he brought milk, he brought pomegranate juice. I said, let's give him an abhishek. Imagine the cowherd boys, how excited they were. They were so excited. We get to bathe Durvasa Muni. He's a very angry sage. He cursed his two wives. He burned them to ash. He's a very angry sage. There's many stories. He was always angry. Anyone didn't do a thing proper, he would give them a curse. So now Krishna's saying, will your anger work with me? So Krishna said, okay, boys, let's give him abhishek. Some boys brought pomegranates and pressed the pomegranate and bathed him in pomegranate juice. Then milk, mango juice, pineapple juice, honey. From the trees direct, nectar is pouring. Maple syrup, banyan syrup, tamal syrup, everything. All the honeybees were there and directly they would take this honey and put it on his head, take the honeybee in the hive, put it there. And he opened his eyes and he saw, oh, Krishna's sitting on my lap. He's pulling my beard and he's asking me, oh Baba, who won the match? This is what Krishna is concerned with. You say, what is God thinking about? Who won the match? Like in boys, you find boys, if they're playing a sport, they're always arguing with each other. If you watch young kids, that's why you have to have referees. If ladies are playing sports, you don't need referees. If boys are playing sports, you have to have referees. The gopis don't have referees. They organize themselves. But the boys need referees, right? It's true. The boys, if you have kids camp, the girls work together sometimes, and the boys sometimes fighting. Okay, so Krishna's arguing with his friends, who's gonna win the match? And he's asking, well, who won the match? But really he's bringing out, you've been meditating on me for thousands of years. You're meditating on me. Now I'm sitting in your lap, pulling your beard. God is relationship. God is personality. You're meditating on me, you're doing yoga. I'm meditating on God. What are you going to do when he's sitting in front of you? This is realization. That is more advanced than a yogi meditating on God. Yogi may meditate on God and realize in his heart, but then Krishna says, come and play with me. So will you play with Krishna and give up your meditation? This is the test. Krishna is saying, will you give up your meditation and play with me? be my referee. Big beard, white beard. So I said, you're a good referee. So then he began to weep, his whole beard. So it was, this was the final Abhishek. Yogurt, milk, ghee, honey, pomegranate juice. That's why when you see, when we do Abhishek, we use pomegranate juice, grape juice, yogurt, milk, honey. But in the end, it was just tears. Tears, that's the real Abhishek. Best Abhishek, just tears. And he was just crying and crying. All my anger, all my curses, everything is lost. Now I'm just seeing you and seeing love for the first time. Now I understand everything. So that's why Bhaktivichara Vishnumar said, don't think, just drink. Okay? Too much thinking means you become mental. So you should suspend this mental process. First, use your mind to go towards Krishna. At a certain point, you should just dive into the ocean and drink and drink and drink and drink. Okay? So this is Durvasa Rishi. So when we do our Gayatri meditation, we're calling Krishna. Come, come, Swaha, come. I'm offering you something. Come, come, Radharani, Radha Krishna, come, come, come. Then they're sitting there. Then what do you do when they come? Oh, let me give you a flower. Simple. When you chant, you think you're here. I cannot see you. I don't have those transcendental eyes. I don't know why my display is off, my audio is off. But I know your display is not off, your audio is not off. So okay, I'm offering you a flower. I'm offering you some sweet. In your mind, you can think, I like rasgullas, I give you rasgulla. Or if you were more advanced, you can think, what do you like? I'll offer you that. Oh, Krishna, you like this? You like Manohar Laddu? I'll give you that. Then give him some sweet, do some arati. Okay, offer your pranam. Then sit there, then he may give you a hug, no problem. He may give you blessing, no problem. But first you offer your meditation. Understand, any important person is coming you love. Okay, you should do some service. This establishes relationships. This is Gayatri Mantra. Okay, so now it's Vrindavan's turn. What page? 108, okay. This is Washington, Analachua, 1999, volume 46, page 108. They are very bosom friends, always living together. So she knows the heart of Radhika, how she comes in separation mood towards Krishna. This is talking about, we have to go backwards. Each department, there are many department heads. Love is so many departments. See, Vrindavan picked a good page. You have to go backwards to understand. Okay? That is why Krishna came in the form of Sachinandan Gaurhari, Mahaprabhu, to taste these three desires of his, which was not tasted even in Krishna Lila. He will have to take training for this. Where will you take training? There's a school in Vrindavan at Radhakund. So our school is a branch office of that school. This is our school. The principal is Srimati Radhika herself. And there are so many professors of each department of that love. Love has so many departments. For each department, there are so many department heads. Lalita, Vishakha, Chitra, and all others. So Mahaprabhu, or Krishna, took admission in the college of Vishakha, Raya Ramananda, because she is such an intimate friend of Radhika. Radhika, Raya Ramananda is Vishakha. Vishakha is one of Radharani's first 8 expansions, and she is same age, born the same day. And they are very close friends. They have a similar mood. Lalita Devi is older. Here's Lalita Devi. And she is a little bit more strong. And she controls. But the most intimate friendship is with Lalita and Vishakha. So Mahaprabhu took admission in the college of Vishakha because she knows everything about Radhika. They both took birth on the same day. They have the same age and their qualities are similar. They are very bosom friends, always living together. So she knows the heart of Radhika, how she comes in a separation mood towards Radhika. This is page 108. How she comes in separation mood. She's becoming happy in meeting Krishna. She knows everything. There's nothing Vishakha does not know. So he was admitted there. Krishna took admittance into the school of Vishakha. In her school, on the bank of the Godavari, and he was studying there for so many days. He finished his study, and then he was examined by Vishakha to see whether you are trained or not. Then he passed the test and he thought, now you should go and do practice. All of this was only theoretical. So Vishakha trained Krishna and said, this is all theory. Now go practice. So Vishakha told him, you should go to the Gambira and I will also be there. I will be there and my eldest Sakhi Lalita will be there also. She will both test you to see whether or not you have understood our lessons. You have passed in theory, but now we will take an examination to see whether you can do it or not. Then Lalita and Vishakha, who are like Raya Ramananda and Swarup Damodara, they were always there, sometimes rebuking, sometimes inspiring that you should come in this line. Sometimes even the principal used to come, Gadadhar Pandit Radhika. He is so high class, he knows everything. Okay, so this is our school. So this is the conclusion. The conclusion is our school. This is our school, and here are our professors and our principal, Srimati Radhika principal, Lalita Vishaka professors, Rupa and Reti, our Gurudev, Prabhupada. They are our administration, and we are just sweeping the floor and hoping that one day they are pleased with us and bring us into their service. Okay? Gaur Pramanandi Hari Hari. Okay, anyone else? Renu, you get to pick one page. Okay, Germany, 1999, volume 47. And this is, we'll finish with this. Okay? That's why I was saying, don't think you have to read forward to back. Don't think, just drink. Open any page and dive into the rest, the nectar. And then, if you have any question, you should also ask Vaishnavs. Whether it is good for you or not, this time or not, everything is good. But how can we follow? Theory is theory, practice is practice. That's what we learned in the last book. Theory is theory, practice is practice. So how to practice, therefore you take living guidance. This is necessary. Okay. So again, we have to go back to the previous sentence. All right. There is no Madhurya Ras, which means the sweetness of the love of the gopis and Radharani and Krishna, in the theory of Ramanujacharya, Madhvacharya, or any Acharya, what to speak of any Mayavadi sannyasis. Bogus, very bogus. Okay, those who follow Buddha, they are blind. They have no idea of the soul and the Supreme Personality of Godhead or anything. We should try to know that in India, we have only one God, not many gods. There are not so many gods. There's only one God. Who is he? That is Krishna, Supreme Personality. Who are Ram and others? They are the same as Krishna, but they are his expansions. They are expansions of Krishna. Shankar, Shiva, Brahma, Durga, what are they? They are not separate from Krishna. They are the energy or the little energies of Krishna only. They are not separate from Krishna. So in India, in Sanatan Dharma, we follow only one God who is one without a second. But you will have to go to any qualified guru to realize and know all these things. So Swamiji, Srila Prabhupada, very soon preached in open centers here and there. He made lakhs and lakhs of disciples in a very short time, but he had no time to train them. So see, Prabhupada established all his books, all his temples, but then he asked Gurudev to come and train my devotees. So there's the principle. Guru, Diksha Guru, Shiksha Guru. So there are so many beautiful things to hear, so many beautiful things to learn. Today we are honoring our beloved Srila Gurudev, praying to him for his mercy, to take his shelter and to please him. And in this way, we are following our Guru Prema. So we'll end with Sai and Arti. Gaur Premanandi, Hari Hari Go, Jai Shri Gurudev. So tomorrow morning, we'll have more katha about Guru Pranima, Sanatana Goswami's disappearance, Sri Vedvyasa's appearance. But today, we are on Guru Pranima, offering all these gifts to Gurudev. There's this idea in scripture. What is our qualification? We are like a candle, flame, and we are worshipping the sun. What does a little candle wick, ye wick, have to offer the sun? We are a little wick, one little soul offering to God, one little flame offering to the supreme flame. So in the same way, we are one palmful of water offering into the river of Mother Ganga. So all these service to Gurudev, this is like us offering a palmful of water to the Ganga. So the best thing is use the Ganga to worship the Ganga. Use Gurudev's words to worship Gurudev. Very simple. And then we should try to adopt this, understand the theory, and practice. Gopri Manandi, Hari Hari.